in 3D. We had discussed about translation, rotation and scaling in 3 dimension. Let's consider one example. Suppose we are having a unit cube. Unit cube means the length of all sides is 1 unit. And this unit cube is translated by the distance 2, 3 and 4 unit. It means through x-axis it is translated by 2 unit, through y-axis it is translated by 3 units, and from z-axis it's translated by 4 unit. This is a unit cube given to us, and for this unit cube I have made this matrix. The matrix is having 4 rows and 8 columns. As the cube is having 8 vertices, so each column is specified for each vertex. So for A, the coordinate, let's see it here, the coordinates of A is 0, 0, 0. So I have written here in the column 1 of this second matrix, 0, 0, 0 and 1. 1 is for the homogeneous coordinates. So in the similar manner, you have to write the matrix for any 3D object given. Suppose you have given a tetrahedron, prism or cube, cuboid, anything that is given. Then you have to make the matrix for that particular solid first of all, and then we have to write the matrix for the operation that we have to perform. Here we have to perform the translation operation, and yesterday we have done the translation matrix is 100 TX, 010 TY, 001 TZ, 001. So here TX is 2, so I have written here 1002, TY is 3, so here it is 0103, TZ is 4, so this is 0014 and 001. Now we have to multiply these two matrices. The resultant matrix is here. So here the first column represents the modified vertex of A. So initially it was 000, now it is 234. B was 100, now this is 334. C was 101, this is 335. D was 001, now it is 235. E was 010, now it is 244. F was 110, now this is 344. G was 111, this is now 345. H was 011, it is now 245. So after translation, the new the coordinates of the new cuboid, new cube is this. So next transformation is tilting transformation. Tilting transformation comes under the category of composite transformation. Composite transformation means it is a combination of two or more elementary transformation. Yesterday we have discussed three elementary transformation: translation, rotation and scaling. Rotation in 3D is rotation is about x axis, rotation about y axis, rotation about z axis. So tilting is a composite transformation. Tilting is defined as a rotation about x axis followed by a rotation about y axis. So here the first, so the tilting composite is a composite transformation. The effect of first transformation, that when we rotate an object about x axis, after rotation that object will lie in the yz plane. So after translating that object through y axis, about y axis, then the vector, the object will align either in x axis or y axis. So suppose let us consider the angle of rotation about x axis is alpha and angle of rotation about y axis is beta. So yesterday we had done the rotation about y axis as well as rotation about x axis as well as rotation about y axis. So here these two matrices, the second one matrix represents a rotation about x axis and the first matrix is a rotation about y axis. So we have to multiply these two matrices. The resultant matrix is the tilting matrix. So inverse tilting matrix is reverse of the above operation. Tilting is rotation about x axis followed by rotation about y axis, but now inverse tilting is rotation about y axis followed by rotation about x axis. So the now order of multiplication of these two matrices is changed. So we'll write first of all the matrix of the rotation about x axis and then rotation about y axis. After multiplication, the resultant matrix is given here. So you can observe one thing, that matrix TXY is not equal to T inverse XY. So tilting matrix is not equal to the inverse of the tilting matrix. So our next stop, as we have started discussion about the composite transformation, so let's consider one more example of the composite transformation. Here the scaling with respect to a fixed point. Suppose this is a 3D object here and XF, YF, ZF is a fixed point. Now yesterday we had discussed scaling with respect to origin. So that matrix that yesterday we have done, that was SX00, 0SY0, 0000SZ0 and 0001. So now instead of scaling with respect to origin, we have to do the scaling with respect to this fixed point XF, YF, ZF. So what we will do, first of all we will translate this point to origin. So for this translation, you can see the third matrix here. When we have translated it, it is 1 0 0 minus XF 0 1 0 minus YF 0 0 1 minus ZF 0 0 0 1. And after translating to the origin, look at the third Cartesian plane. Now we have to scale the object as per the scaling vector. So whatever the value of SX, SY, SZ, we have to scale the object. So second matrix is for the scaling that we had discussed yesterday about with respect to origin. After scaling that object, that then you have to translate that fixed point back to its original position. For translating back to its original position, look at the first matrix, that is 1 0 0 XF, 0 1 0 YF, 0 0 1 ZF, 0 0 0 1. So after multiplication of these three matrix, the resultant matrix is SX 0 0 1 minus SX XF, 0 SY 0 1 minus SY YF, 0 0 SZ 1 minus SZ ZF, 0 0 0 1. So this is the resultant matrix of the scaling with respect to the fixed point. Thank you.
Thank you.